Welcome to the Expat Life Lessons Podcast, the podcast made for expats, where you get ready for coaching tips and life lessons to help you feel more at home no matter where you are based.
Also get ready for silly jokes, funny stories, and the truth of what it means to be an expat.
I'm Mariana.
And I am Alina.
So let's get started.
Hello, my name is Mariana. Welcome to the Expat Life Lessons Podcast. I'm an expat coach and I'm one of the co-hosts of this podcast. And today will be a more practical episode, like all of my solo episodes are, which is really meant to give you practical tips for you to really create a life you love as an expat. Because that's my mission as an expat coach, is really to empower expats to really create like a life you love no matter where you are. I know sometimes it can really feel like it is a struggle, it can feel stressful, and I'm here to support you with your journey. So today, the goal is really to talk about setting realistic expectations, like what are you going to expect in your life as an expat? So there are a lot of things around here that I wanted to discuss. And one of the things is really when you are, let's say you are moving for the first time and you don't really know what to expect. When this happens, our minds can turn into a more negative approach or more like, oh, will I just feel lonely? Will it be very hard? I know that's how I felt when I moved from Portugal to Scotland, definitely. But sometimes, let's say you were an expat before in another country and now you moved to a new one and it was quite easy in that country and now you're moving to the new one, you are expecting it to be easy and it's not. So here, as you can see, it's very different types of expectations that we might have. And then we might even not really have that many expectations. We might just be like, oh, when I get there, I'll see. So here is one thing I always tell my clients when they come to me, when they are struggling. It is like, what would be a realistic expectation of how you want your life to turn like, to be like? How you want your life to look like? Because sometimes we don't really know what to expect and we don't really want to set a goal because we are afraid it won't really happen. And we don't really know, okay, but what is an expectation I can have? What is an expectation I shouldn't have? So what I always say is create a realistic expectation. So what I mean by this is, of course, you never know what will happen, but the more that you create some expectation or let's say a goal around your life, the more that you'll be intentional with it. Look at it like, let's say you put a direction in your GPS and you know where you want to go, but you might want to stop in the way. You might want to change the direction and that's totally fine. But when we talk about expectations, about what we are looking for in our lives as expats, it can be challenging to know what to expect. So let's say like you want to make friends, you want to find a partner, you want to find your accommodation. And the expectation that you might have is that you will get there. And I can tell you, you will. You will get there. Now, the thing is, let's say, if you don't know anyone in this new place and you don't have an accommodation right now, maybe it wouldn't really be a realistic expectation to think that you'll have it all in a month. Maybe it will be more 3 months, 6 months. So that way, you don't put so much pressure on yourself and so much of focusing so much on the results and not so much on the journey. And you are always free to send me a message and ask me any questions about this, by the way, on my Instagram. But so one thing I wanted to talk to you about in this situation is really like, what can you control on it? Because sometimes one of the things that will make us feel the most stressed out, the most overwhelmed, is when we feel that things aren't going our way and we thought that we could make it happen and we don't really know what's happening. So one thing I tell always to my clients is focus on what you can control. And trust me, before I was a coach and like a few years ago, if you would have asked me what can you control, I would have told you everything. Because I wasn't really like thinking about all the tiny things. I was just like, oh, I want to have friends. I can control that outcome. I want this to happen. I can control that outcome and so on. And then when it didn't happen exactly as I imagined it, I was like blaming myself. I was like thinking, oh, but I should be able to do this. Oh, but I should be able to have that result that I want. And I would put so much pressure on myself to make certain results happen, because I wasn't so focused on what efforts I was making. I was more focused, am I having the results I want or not? And I was really being, well, I think the right word is I was being a tiny bit mean to myself. And I see this with my clients, and I think most of us, like, sometimes we look and we are like, oh, I wouldn't really talk to my best friend the way that I talk to myself. And so this was here a smaller pause in the topic, but with this, what I meant to tell you is really that when you are focusing on your expectations, on your goals, what can you control on it? And this is one exercise that I always do with my clients and that I want to share here with you on this podcast, which is, let's say you are, I don't know, you want to make friends. What can you control while making friends? Maybe you can control the actions you take. Maybe you can control where you post that you are looking for friends. Maybe you can control what type of events you go to. Maybe you can even control how you plan your day so that you try and get the energy you need. And then, what do you have some control over, but not totally? And really look at that as well. Maybe you have some control over what, like how you are going to talk with people. Maybe you have some control over, let's say, how many people you talk to, and so on. And then, what don't you have any control over? Like anything. People's reactions. People's personalities. How people react to you, even. You have zero control over that. And the goal of this exercise, so the main question is, what can you control? What do you have some control over? And what don't you have any control over? Is really to help you focus on what are the things that you have a lot of control over. Because the more that you focus on it, the more that, let's say, you have here the goal, and you have here where you are right now, and the more that you can control, okay, I have control over my own actions. So what is like a tiny, let's say, 5-minute action that I can do to move a tiny bit closer to my goal? What is something I can control? Because doing this, it will really empower you to see that you do have control over the results that you get. You might not have control over the timeline all the time. You might not have control how people will react or where you will meet them. Maybe you think, I will meet my people on this event. And it doesn't happen because instead of being like 50 people, it was like 5 and you didn't really connect with them. So maybe you didn't have control over it. But what you do have control over is how many events you go to. How is your vibe? How is your energy in that? And even thinking, what type of people do you connect with the most? So all of this to say, when you are moving to a new place as an expat, or you're even like already in this new city, in this new country, and you're feeling overwhelmed, one of the things is really setting realistic expectations of how you want your life to be like, of the timelines that you want your life to be like, and really to focus on what actions you can take right now instead of focusing on everything in your life, because this can be very overwhelming. And this is what we don't want. My goal here is really to help you really lose the overwhelm, really learn how to cope with your emotions, really learn how to cope with stress, really learn how to tolerate more stress, but also to plan ahead so that you don't have so much stress in your life. And this is one of the ways, is really focusing on what immediate actions you can take right now and what can you actually control right now to go and move towards any expectations that you have. So I would love if you would send me a comment about this podcast, about what you are thinking about it, what would help you the most in your journey as an expat. Let me know. I'm always here. I'm always open to any feedback you have. And if you need any more help, send me a message. We can talk about it. If you just need help by message, if you want to have a one-on-one coaching session to see how that is, to see how I could help you in your journey, I'm more than happy to help you out, and let me know. I hope you have a beautiful day. Thank you for tuning in, and talk to you next time.